We're here today with Daniel Majeske, who is running for Waterford School District. How are you today?
I'm doing very well, thank you. We're actually having a little bit of sunshine at the moment. We had gloom and rain all morning, and it's nice to see the sun come out a little bit.
Yeah, for sure. Can you tell us why you've decided to run for the school board?
Yes, Crystal, I have 52 years experience in education. 38 years I taught a secondary level, mainly high school. And when I retired, I began teaching part-time at Oakland University, and I've been there now 14 years. This is my 14th year. And I know that I made a difference in the lives of my students, both at the secondary level, mainly high school, for 38 years full-time, and now helping to train teachers at Oakland University. Their academic lives, their interpersonal lives, I know I made a difference. And I'm at that point in my life where I would like to make a difference for the community in which I live. I made a choice when I retired from full-time to be current and relevant in education. And OU gave me that opportunity for teaching undergraduate students and graduate students. It has also given me the opportunity for continual professional development myself, for methods or what we might call best practice. We have a term from teachingworks.org out of University of Michigan Ann Arbor that's called high leverage teaching practices that we teach our student teaching interns. And the state of Michigan this year is adopting those and calling them core teaching practices. So I enjoy feeling like I'm on the cutting edge of what's going on. And I joined the field office in order to be able to work with student teaching interns. I've been to dozens of high schools, middle schools across Oakland and Macomb counties. My work includes observations that are written in digital, lesson plans, classroom management, teaching strategies, assessments of interns, how they give assessments to students. I work with the student teaching interns in seminars on campus, although everything is virtual at the moment. And I plan to continue to do this, to remain current and relevant. I have loved my profession. I love what I do at Oakland University. So I would like to go to 60 years and then think about permanent retirement at that point. I could bring this wide array of experience that I have to Waterford schools. And as a board member, I could bring my perspective for what the district needs would be going forward.
So what are some of those things you want to work on if you're elected?
There are several. First of all, because of my involvement at Oakland University, I would like to see Waterford schools, the high schools and middle schools, have a partnership with Oakland in terms of the student teaching interns that we have. There are benefits that go both ways. Not only will my student teaching interns learn a lot by teaching in a district like Waterford, but I have had mentor teachers over the years often tell me that they learned many things from their student teaching interns. A good example of that would be this past spring when the COVID-19 came to us and we had to move from teaching in person to virtual everywhere. One of my student teaching interns was in math. She taught the whole math department at this large high school how to teach mathematics virtually by remote. I had a student teaching intern in science. She did the same thing with the science department at her school. I had a student teaching intern in social studies. Her mentor teacher told me he could not have survived that transition without her help. she was invaluable to him. And it's not just this past year and the pandemic. I've had mentors tell me over the years that they picked up little things from their interns. Even though these are veteran teachers, they were open to picking up some new things and they enjoyed that contact. And then of course, my student teaching interns learned a lot about how to teach, what we call pedagogy, and for professional disposition, how they should conduct themselves in a classroom. So in addition to that, that partnership, I would like to work on the allocation of resources for the district. I would, with the funds that are available, I would like to know that we're spending them in the best places. We have to pay close attention to special populations, especially special ed. There are achievement gaps, and those achievement gaps need to be closed. Students need knowledge, and they need skills if they're going to have equal opportunities. But at the same time, we can't ignore our gifted and talented students either. So there's a wide range. And in the classroom, we teach our student teaching interns to differentiate their teaching so that they can reach all levels of students. And as a board member, I would want to make sure that as a district, we are doing that district-wide, that we are meeting the needs of all of our students. I also would like to make sure that the district is having continuous professional development for their administration and their teaching staff. They need development on digital tools. I found it's a struggle for me to keep up with digital tools. I like the fact that I can do the things that I'm able to do and what I've learned. But I, as a board member, I would want to make sure that everyone was comfortable. And as much as possible, we would have that professional development, not just for best practice and core teaching practices, but also for personal dispositions and creating and making a building and culture, the buildings and the culture of the district and the cultures of the buildings friendly and welcoming. As I went to buildings across Oakland and Macomb County, I discovered that there are a lot of different cultures from district to district. Some are very welcoming, some are not. And there can be a wide variance even within one particular school district. Some buildings are very welcoming and some are not. They sort of tolerate you being there. And I would like to see Waterford schools be very welcoming and including. And that would be for race, ethnicities, ESL, English as a second language, sexual orientation, our LGBTQ plus students, and staff, that staff would feel they could teach in the district and be comfortable and not worry that there would be some type of discrimination because of who they are. So those are the items I would like to focus on. And I'm certain that if I was elected to the school board, there'd be many more things that would come up. That's always the case.
So what are some of the ways you've been involved in the community and in the schools?
Okay, this is a good question. And let me kind of hold several threads together in that. I've lived in Waterford for 30 years. This has been my community for a large part of my lifetime. Now I expect to live here until my end of life, or if at some point I have to go to independent or assisted living. So I am concerned about the community. However, I have two married daughters and seven grandchildren, and I'm very happy about that. My daughters lived with their mother after our divorce. So they grew up in a different school district. And both of my daughters have careers, and my sons-in-laws have careers, and those careers have fortunately kept them in the state of Michigan, but not real close to me. And so my grandchildren are growing up in different school districts. But that doesn't mean I don't participate as much as possible. Just yesterday, I was at a soccer game for one of my six-year-old grandsons. I went to as many things as I could for my daughters when they were growing up. I participated in as many things, basketball games, soccer games, football games. I have four grandsons and three granddaughters. And everything that comes up that I'm able to participate in, I will. And when I taught full-time, it was in the Holly School District, I chaperoned dozens of dances. I did the stats for the ninth grade basketball team for 2 years, home and away. Now this is all volunteer. I did the stats for the varsity baseball team for 4 years, home and away. I was the yearbook advisor for 12 years. And I learned a lot about Holly schools. For example, their current high school is the fourth one. The school district is over 140 years old. And the second new Holly High School in 1913 saved $2,000 by using the bricks from the original building, the same bricks. So I learned a lot about the school district. And at Oakland University, I have volunteered for convocation, for teacher education days. I've attended suicide prevention seminars that were volunteer. The university offers faculty online courses and seminars on campus for professional development. And I have taken many of those. Some of those are digital. And I say all that because I do not have any current and have not had a lot of active involvement in Waterford schools, but I would want people to know that I bring that same level of commitment. I have been involved in my family and in my work, and wherever I've been very involved and I've done a lot of volunteer work, and I would bring that same level of commitment to Waterford schools. So even though I can't point to anything specific that I've done for Waterford, I would want people to know that I have that level of commitment. It would have felt a little awkward to walk into Waterford schools without being a parent, without having, you know, without being employed in the district and say, hey, I want to volunteer for this. And besides, it was quite busy with the things that I was doing anyway.
So in this race, there is some competition for these seats. Why should the voters pick you?
Well, they should consider me strongly and pick me as one of the choices because of my level of commitment, my 52 years of experience. I feel like I understand schools. I understand school districts. I could walk into Waterford schools. I could sit on the school board without there being much of a learning curve. I have a background and with Oakland University now for 14 years. In fact, my bachelor's is from Oakland University. I have an over 50-year experience with Oakland University. I did most of my Master of Arts in teaching. I have an education specialist from there. And in my current role, I could bring partnerships and resources to Waterford schools from the university that could be beneficial. So between commitment, experience, I think that people should strongly consider me. And this is something I want to do. I'm at that point in my life where I'd like to really do something for the community in which I live. This would be the opportunity, even though I don't have a close connection with, say, children or grandchildren in the district.
So So if the voters want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
They can go to the Michigan Education Justice Coalition. I completed an extremely long survey for the Coalition, Justice Coalition. They could contact me at dmajeske@comcast.net. And I hope to have a website up in the very near future.
Great. Well, thank you so much for doing the interview with us today.
Well, Crystal, thank you very much for this opportunity. I've enjoyed it. I've enjoyed talking with you. I hope you have a great rest of the day.